Thank you very much. I would like to begin with extending my solidarities with the women of Afghanistan who are right now facing very, very difficult circumstances. I was asked by Razia to speak on political participation of women in India. So first of all, let me also congratulate everyone that we have entered the 75th year of our independence. And as soon as we got our independence in 1947 and the Constitution of India was being written and finally adopted in 1950, the Constitution gave, under the Article 326, gave equal voting rights to women in this country. In the beginning, women did not vote like the men because of illiteracy and a lot of other problems. But if we look at the 2014 figures, 65.6% women voted as against 67.09%. Almost men. Equal. So as far as participation in the whole process of democracy is concerned, women are equal participants there, and they vote as much. In fact, there are many little states where women have even percentage-wise voted more than the men have voted. India has also seen very important and very well-known women as the Prime Minister of this country, as many chief ministers, president of the country, and Speaker of the Lok Sabha. We also have women in various legislative assemblies, 0.9% men, which is almost equal. But the reality is that as against 50% of the population, the women in parliament is hardly 11% as we stand today. And recently, 5 assemblies had gone to polls. The number of women who were given tickets in those elections, there was 9% women given tickets in Kerala, 7.8% in Assam, and 11% women in Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, and Puducherry. So while we participate and vote almost as many men vote, but in terms of the participation in political processes, women are nowhere in competition. They are far, far behind. The latest Global Gender Gap Index, according to that, India stands at 140th place out of 156 countries. And this has slipped 28 in the last few years. I mean, we were better off than this before this government came to power. Also, I would like to say that 12th of September, which is just about 2 weeks away, marks the 25th anniversary of the Women Reservation Bill, when the whole struggle started for women to get reservation in parliament and in assemblies. Women have been demanding 33% reservation, 1/3 seats in parliament and assemblies. But this has been a long, long battle, 25 years, as I said. Finally, in 2010, the bill got passed in Rajya Sabha, but it never got passed in Lok Sabha. There were many hurdles. I was also looking before this, I thought I'll quickly look at what is the women's representation in political parties. Parliament elected members is one thing, but are the political parties giving representation to women? I looked at 2 websites. One was Congress. The AICC has 92 office bearers. Out of that, 7 are women. And CPM, which is the Communist Party of India Marxist Central Committee, that has 94 members. Out of that, 15 are women. So even within political parties, and these are political parties which are probably more conscious about women participation. I have not looked at other political parties, but within the political parties, there is hardly equal, what about equal, not even 10% participation of women. And the major reasons are, of course, as Razia mentioned, that patriarchal mindset, which is the patriarchy, is overpowering in India. And it is very difficult to change those mindsets. There is also no conviction on the, in the political parties to give space to women. When we were fighting for for passing of the women reservation bill, I had a conversation with a top leader of one of the political parties. I won't name the person, and I was told that, you know, we do want to pass the bill, but the men in our party are very unhappy about this. So political parties are even unable to convince their own members that women participation is very important. Women who enter politics, they face all kinds of derogatory remarks, both within the parliament, within the assemblies and outside. And the worst example which one can quote and one has witnessed in the recent past is that the prime minister of this country was catcalling Mamata Banerjee during the elections. The way he said didi o didi, it's like, you know, jis tarah gali ke nukkad pe lafange khade hoke ladkiyon ke upar awazein kaste hain, bilkul it was the same tone and same way. So when the prime minister of a country is involved in this kind of things, you can understand what the rest of the men probably how they behave and how they think. The way forward is that all of us must keep fighting. We are going to observe 25 years of the Women Reservation Bill, the process when it started 25 years ago. It is important that we re-emphasize that this bill must be passed in the parliament in the coming winter session. And these voices should come out from every part of India to ensure that women get representation at the policy level. Because unless we are there at the policy level, we have seen during the pandemic, countries where women prime ministers were there, they fared much, much better than other countries. So there is a need, an urgent need to have women in politics and many more women than what is there at the moment. Thank you very much.